Hi, this video is about how to do your taxes. And whether you use a computer software or internet program to do your taxes, it's still really good to understand what is going on with the calculation, or if you could do it by hand with the paper forms. So let's go through all the vocabulary and the formula of how the taxes are calculated. If you need this worksheet, you can get it on my website at carolemath.com. Okay, oh, the other thing I should say is I am not a tax professional. So I'm a math teacher. And so we're going through this calculation, but this does not constitute tax advice, okay? So, gross income. The first thing you start with is all of your income that you have earned through the year, okay? So this is your total income. And that's from all sources like wages, or salary, tips, interest on any bank accounts, also includes child support. Okay, any income that you have that adds up to your gross income. Then we have adjustments, which are called above the line deductions. These are things that are paid pre-tax. So things like retirement, IRAs or 401ks, and also benefits. So if there's anything that you get subtracted out of your paycheck before they calculate the taxes, that is called an above the line deduction. So this is pre-tax. Things like 401k, IRAs, and benefits. Okay, for example, you may get health insurance through your employer, and if you have to pay some or all of it, they would subtract that out before they calculate your withholdings. Okay, so once they take all that out of your paycheck and you take it all out for at the end of the year, then that's called your adjusted gross income or AGI. It's your adjusted gross income. You hear that acronym a lot, AGI. Okay, but you still don't have to pay taxes on the AGI. You get to subtract two things. The first thing is called the deductions. The second thing is called the exemption. So the first thing is you get to take the higher of either the standard deduction or the itemized, your itemized deductions. So let me show you how the tax table here. This is for 2017 tax year. Okay, so depending on your filing status, if you're filing single, you get to deduct $6,350 from your income, from your AGI. If you're married filing jointly, $12,700. Head of household, $9,350. So this is an additional benefit. You get to subtract this amount from your income. Okay, now what are the itemized deductions though? Everyone gets the standard deduction. But itemized deductions are additional tax benefits. So if you own a home, then you can claim mortgage interest as a deduction. So that's a big one for homeowners, mortgage interest. Another thing you get to deduct are donations to charity. Some other things you might be able to deduct are medical expenses or work expenses, but they have to be a sizable amount. So there's a qualifications for that in the tax forms or in the tax software. So those are a maybe, but those are the types of things that would add up to your itemized deduction. So you want to get, usually people want to get as much of these as they can and see if it adds up to higher than the standard deduction. If so, then they can claim the itemized deductions. So you want whichever is higher. either the standard deduction or your own itemized deductions. Okay, so you're going to subtract that off your AGI. The other thing is you get a personal exemption for each person claimed on the return. So if you are filing single, you would get one exemption. So here's the personal exemption right here. And this is per person. You'll get these tax forms in class when we practice these, or tax tables, sorry. So this is per person. So if you're single, you would get one of these. If you are married filing jointly, you would get two, this times two. Married with one kid, you get three. Married with two kids, you get four. You get the idea. That's per person for each person on the return. Okay, so once you take out either the standard deduction or the itemized deduction and your personal exemption or exemptions, that is equal to your taxable income. Okay, so taxable income is actually what your taxes are calculated on. And there are some tables. We'll look at this when we do an example. But these are tax tables, or computer software just calculates it for you, to tell you how much tax that you actually owe. Okay, so once you find the amount of tax, that's the tax amount from the tables. When you subtract that, equals your taxable income. Okay, so you find your tax amount from your tables. Then there's one more thing that you might get to subtract, and those are called tax credits. It's really great to get a tax credit because that directly reduces the taxes you have to pay. The deductions are great. They save you a percentage, but this is dollar for dollar. This directly reduces the tax you have to pay, and that equals your taxes due. Okay, so things that you might get a tax credit for, there's a child tax credit if you have children. There's also something called an earned income credit. Sometimes people actually get money back for having a credit, so a tax credit is a very good thing to have. Okay, so you take the amount. When your tax is calculated, you subtract any credits, and that's the amount of taxes that are due to the government. Now, if you've been getting paychecks all throughout the year, your employer has been subtracting some money out for taxes. And that's really important, so you don't have this huge tax bill at the end of the year. So those are called withholdings. Withholdings is taken out of your paycheck. If you have your own business, you might be making quarterly payments. Okay, so if your withholdings are less than the taxes due, so they didn't withhold enough, if they didn't withhold as much as you owe, then you're going to owe money. You have to pay the difference. Nobody really wants to pay taxes, even though they go for very important benefits. If your withholdings are more than your taxes due, that means you more was taken out than you actually owe. So that's when you get a refund. Okay, so if you want a little recap, I'll just go through it quickly again. So our gross income, that's the total amount of income that you earn from all the different sources. Adjustments are things that are pre-tax, so we subtract those, and that's the adjusted gross income. Okay, then we get to take out the deduction and the exemption. So you want the higher of either the standard deduction or the itemized deductions. You subtract that. You also subtract the personal exemption for each person claimed on the return. That's your taxable income. So you take that taxable income, and that's what the tax is calculated on from a table or computer if you're doing your taxes that way. Then you use that to find out the amount of tax you owe, the amount of tax from the tables. If you have any tax credits, you get to take that off, and that's your taxes due. Now you've had withholdings throughout the year. So if your withholdings are less than the taxes due, then you're going to owe the difference. You have to pay money, more money to the government. If your withholdings were more than your taxes, then you get a refund. And so that's why usually people are trying to subtract as much as they can here, 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 and here to get their tax amount down so that they will get a refund. Okay, so that is an overview of all this terminology and the calculation, and we'll do an example in the next video. So I'll see you there.